See, what we're doing, here's what we're doing. We're earning money in our job, right? And then we're giving 45% of our job. And with what's left,
wonderful time in my employment. No, needs more blue there. No, more navy. Little bit of... Hello?
Hand it over.
What do you want?
Give it to me. I know you're trying to hide it.
I have no clue what you're talking about.
Do not lie to me, Cassandra Muzu. I know I will find it sooner or later.
Please, no. It can't be.
I'll give you one last chance before I will come get it myself.
Get what?
The secret of your painting.
Oh, this is so much work. Hello?
Mr. MacArthur, please. We need to talk.
Look, Cassandra, I'm busy right now. So can you just call back?
William, it's urgent.
Fine. Call me Mr. MacArthur or else. What is it now?
I need access security.
What for?
Someone is after my painting.
Hello?
I have a case for you.
What? A murdered celebrity? A stolen artifact?
A Ferrari smuggled theft?
Nothing quite on that level. A painting.
Oh. So that means no explosives.
It is no ordinary painting.
It is by the owner, Cassandra Muzu.
Really? The Cassandra Muzu?
Yes. Your job is to guard the painting and make sure no secrets get out.
Come to the Bay Area Museum of Art tomorrow at 10 a.m. sharp.
So, I'm hired?
You're hired.
So, you must be Mr. MacArthur.
That is correct. And you must be Andrew M. Stewart.
Yeah. So why is Cassandra Muzu here?
I have her working on a painting that will be in this museum.
Cool. So where is she?
Right here. Got a problem with that? So here I am slaving away working on some stupid painting that you want to go in your museum, and I get no time to work on it all because of you!
Please, Cassandra.
I don't care! Some crazy guy just called me and threatened me about my painting. Now I want to see some action. Arrest that guy so I can get some peace and quiet!
Sorry about that. She isn't usually like that. Well,
actually she is.
So that's why you hired me.
Sorry?
You really wanted me to find out who's been threatening Cassandra.
Yes, I admit it. At first I didn't want to believe it myself, but now it seems that Cassandra could be in greater danger than ever.
No, Cassandra, you're just being silly. No one will ever find out the secret under the painting. Yes, that's it. Now let's get back to thinking on that painting. What do you want?
Don't you know the secret of your painting?
You're the one who called me before.
I thought that was obvious. Now hand it over!
It's not here. I put the painting in some place that you'll never find it.
Where is it?
It's in the museum.
Give me the painting!
Never!
What is the secret of your painting?
There is no secret.
Give it to me!
Can't believe it. Cassandra is crazy, you know. But...
Hello?
Mr. MacArthur, are you there?
I was just informed of the death.
You will? I was gonna
inform you. It's very sad. No clues of any kind left behind. Just blood.
Well, I read about the murder in the paper. The body was autopsied this morning. Word spread out quickly.
Should I come over to the museum to see the files of Cassandra?
Yes, straight away.
Well, I better get my equipment then, Mr.
One more thing, Stuart.
She has a twin sister, identical. She might be of use.
She is very eager to help you on the case. Her name is Charlene Muzu.
You arrived. Oh, good. I wanted to introduce you to Charlene. She just came up in her car, very sad about it all, crying her eyes out. Well, she was. Now she's examining the painting for what she thinks are important clues.
So, Mr. MacArthur, I want to see her. I want to question her about Cassandra.
Yes, of course. But I have a feeling that she wants to question you first. But please comfort her, just so you know she is a fashion model. And fashion models do put more emphasis on beauty than brains. Oh, look! There she is now!
Director.
Are you the janitor?
Yes, miss, I am. What do you want?
Do the words "weight management" mean anything to you?
Shut your mouth, you little cheeky!
So are you the detective?
Yes. Andy Ann Stewart.
What does the M stand for?
Marion.
Isn't that the girl's name?
It's confidential. Well, Charlene, I'm sorry about, you know. You guys must have been like two peas in a pod.
Yeah. Wait. But I thought Pond only had one pea. But doesn't
have an F or an L or a 2 or a 47?
Well, Shirley, this is Detective Andy, and he's here to help the case of Miss Cassandra Muzu's murder.
Yes, Ben. Well, Charlene, where were you the night of the murder?
Easy. I was in my room drinking my fashion medicine and reading magazines.
Do you know anything about this painting the killer killed her for?
Yes. Wait. I'm confused.
Do you know anything about the painting?
I don't get it. I think I should go take my smartity medicine.
She wants to help you find out who killed her sister. You'd better let her. She usually gets enthusiastic when it comes to helping people out.
Why not? I must find some clues for this case. I'll search this whole museum and question all her friends, enemies, and anyone who ever knew her.
Here's a copy of Cassandra's files. My other employees, too. Look at them carefully. You just may find something.
Name, Cassandra O'Keefe Mizzou. Job, artist. Relatives, Joyce Leona Mizzou, Jonathan Daniel Mizzou, Charlene Luna Mizzou. Previous jobs, astronomy teacher? To see you.
Oh my gosh, yeah, I've totally been having the greatest time the last 4 hours. I've been shopping at Versace, Prada, Donna Karan, Victoria's Secret, Gucci, and I found this new kind of jelly donut that's low in carbs and high in yum.
Okay then.
Listen, I wanted to ask you some questions about your sister Cassandra.
Oh my gosh, we could totally go shopping together for miniskirts. You're probably an extra large. I wonder if there's an obese size.
Charlene.
Yeah?
I wanted to ask you some questions about your sister Cassandra.
Oh my gosh! I love questions! Once in school, I got a 99% on a quiz that had questions. Was I holding the quiz upside down?
Never mind. Charlene, I know you are very smart.
Definitely!
yeah. So now I'm going to ask you the questions.
Okay, I'm ready.
First question. Okay. Do you have any idea why some crazy guy was threatening your sister?
Probably because he was in love and he didn't want anybody to find out. Love makes the world go round.
Sure then. Do you think the threats have any connections to, I don't know, a painting?
Cassie loved paintings. She was an artist, you know.
I know that. So why did someone call and kill her? Did Cassie have anyone who really hated her?
Uncle. O-F-H.
Right.
I'm like totally serious. He's been trying to take all the family's business for years so he can rule the ecology.
Oh, wow. He sounds like a guy who would threaten his own niece and even kill her. And by the way, do you mean rule the economy?
I don't know. Ecology. Economy. Echolocationography. They all sound the same.
What is this?
I just saw there's something.
What? Did you work out the real reason why Cassandra was murdered? Did you solve the whole mystery behind the phone call? What?
I.
Yes?
I thought we could go on a diet together. Was it something I said?
I've got to tell Stuart about this.
Oliver Frederick Hobart?
Hello? Stuart,
there's something very important that I forgot to tell you about.
What? What is it?
You know the phone call where the man had threatened Cassandra?
Yes.
I managed to obtain the original phone call from her phone company and, well, you'd better just listen.
So that's why the killer called, for the secret of the painting.
Yes, I believe Cassandra has hidden it in the museum. Didn't you say that Cassie used to be an astronomy teacher?
An astronomy teacher. I wonder why she painted the painting in the first place.
It was entitled Full Moon. She created abstract art and impressionist paintings such as this one. Cassie used to always be so paranoid about getting killed. It is a shame that she never got to write her will.
Mr. MacArthur, say that again.
What?
Say what you just said.
Okay. What?
No, I mean when you say it's a shame that Cassandra never got to write her will.
What are you possibly getting at?
The painting is her will. The will is in the painting.
Stuart, you know it's highly unlikely.
There are almost no signs of writing anywhere.
It is a confusing piece of work.
Yeah, I'm like totally confused. I didn't know there was somebody named Will involved.
Don't you get it? Since she was so paranoid about getting killed, she wrote a will on the painting. That's why she was killed, because somebody wanted to find her will.
Oh, I get it.
You do?
Will is her boyfriend. Sometimes the angel just stares me right in the face.
Well, we don't know anything until we have the painting.
Yeah. But where could it be?
I wonder what's in this door. Oh my gosh, I love this museum.
Right here in the middle of this room.
OMG! This is Cassie's painting. It looks weird.
Charlene.
I found Cassie's painting.
Really? The full moon?
Yes! Full the moonie! I found it! Full the moonie!
Could you please stop screaming?
Stuart, this may be a perfect time to test your theory.
Right, let's try and look for clues. I remember something relevant, but what was it? I should try to remember. Name, Cassandra O'Keefe Mizzou. Previous jobs. Astronomy teacher. Mr. MacArthur, didn't you say that Cassandra used to be an astronomy teacher and in the painting there is a full moon? Don't you think that's a little strange?
Yes, I do see your point, Stuart, but Will's her will.
What is it, Charlene?
I like totally recognize where this painting is. It's in my cousin's backyard. Wow.
Really?
It is?
Yeah.
So we should go check it out.
is it, Charlene?
Well, this is where Cassie and I used to play when we were kids, before Cassie died. Well, obviously not me. I just did my nails while Cassie f***ed herself up.
Jack said that.
Oh my god. I totally feel the same way that you do. I actually had to do my own nails back then.
Well,
I propose we come back in 2 days at 5 o'clock p.m.
Why?
Because in 2 days at 5 o'clock p.m., there will be the next full moon. We just may find some clues.
What is it, Stuart?
The sky's cloudy. I can't see the full moon at all.
Why don't we need to?
Because the painting is entitled Full Moon. That would be the most obvious clue in the painting.
I see your point, Andrew, but what difference would that make? If the painting was Cassandra's will, there would have to be some other hint besides just a full moon.
Let's just start with what we have. Where in the sky would the full moon actually be?
Oh, I remember that the moon always used to be over that bench.
Okay, so what would the next clue be?
Let's look at the painting.
This is a weird painting. It's all swirly and twirly, and it makes me confused.
Wait, why is that rock so realistic and detailed? It has such a long shadow. It has got to be a rock in the painting. Come on.
This rock doesn't look unusual.
No, but look at the shadow of the rock in the painting. It zigzags. It must be pointing somewhere. Look, over there.
Look, treasure.
It's got to be Cassandra's will.
And it's all mine.
It's the man who killed Cassandra.
Oh! Ah!
She put a skirt on my head.
That was some quick thinking, Miss Lucy.
I'm glad I went shopping for mini skirts.
Come on, let's take this bum over to the police.
Well, Stuart, it looks like you've solved the whole case of the full moon.
Maybe. Now I think I just need to get the facts straight. When Charlene told me the only person who really hated Cassandra was her uncle, Uncle O.F.H., I noticed the same name in Mr. MacArthur's files, except it's Oliver Frederick Hobart. That is your name, isn't it?
How did you know?
Good. Anyway, you wanted to kill Cassandra because you knew that there was a secret in the painting. In order to kill her, you had to keep a close eye on her. That was why you poisoned the old janitor Huggins, so that you could get his job. When you got the job as janitor, it was easy for you to murder your niece and look for the painting. When you found it, you hid it in the employee's only room to come back for it later. Soon the day came when it was a full moon, so you went back to the room, only to find that the painting was gone. Anyway, you still went to your backyard to find us. We captured you, and now here you are.
But why did he want to find out the secret of the painting in the first place?
It was so he could obtain her will, sell the painting, and be rich. Then he could take over the family's business and rule the economy.
How did the janitor know the will was in her painting?
Oliver Frederick Hobart was Cassandra's uncle. Easily, he could have overheard it. Charlene, did your family have reunions or gatherings with this man?
Oh my gosh! I hated those family gatherings. They were all high in calories and...
Thank you. So this man could have overheard Cassandra talking to herself.
Oh my gosh, Cassandra always talked to herself nonstop. I hate it.
Thank you. I now declare this man guilty.
We'll settle it in court, but I thank you for your generous help. Goodbye now. Come on, you.
Charlene, because of your quick thinking to catch Cassandra Hobart and wish all the way, I now promote you to the rank of junior detective.
So I got a qualification?
Yeah.
Thank you! Was it something I
gotta pick it up like a call. I'm a hit and I'm leaving that latch on to it until tomorrow, yeah.
Shawty, I can see that you got so much energy.
The way you're twirling up them hips round and round.
There's no reason at all why you can't leave here with me.
In the meantime, stay, let me watch you break it down, hey.